Later that same evening, we were treated to the Intercontinental Dream Match, pitting two of Ring of Honor's finest, Bryan Danielson and Samoa Joe versus Pro Wrestling Noah Duo Kenta and Naomichi Murafuji. Sorry if I said that wrong. Sweet. These are really nice calls. I will tag in Kenta. Another. Oh, my God. Can he get the pin? 1, 2. Oh my goodness. They got the fast pin on Joe and Bryan. That was like one of the fastest matches I've ever seen. Absolutely no drama. Just a straight up wrestling match. Oh my goodness. That was way too easy. Whoever was videotaping that might want to do that over again, because that completely sucked as a match. After Best in the World, Nigel went on a tour of Japan for Pro Wrestling Noah, while Danielson continued his dominance and produced an open contract to challenge anyone in the world to face him for the world title. That challenge would be answered, but first he had to go through an old nemesis by the name of Roderick Strong. This dragon's 19 defense of the title and a 56-minute classic at Supercard of Honor. This is going to be amazing. The very next night, Danielson would face the answer to his open contract from none other than a recently retired veteran, Lance Storm. Storm comes out of retirement for one last shot at the world title at Better Than Our Best from Chicago, Illinois. Whoa, that was a little bit too easy. I was about to hit him with like a knee and then tap him out with the cattle mutilation. But I didn't know that move would get him. So thank you guys for watching this part. And head on down to the other part, guys. As we draw closer and closer to the big match. Thank you guys for watching. Stay gold.